Welcome to Good News. So, what have we learnt this week? Well, this woman revealed the dullest hobby ever.
For a while, I used to keep a list in my bag of towns beginning with Y, because there weren't many. Anyway.
When going on telly, make sure you know what you're going to say.
Constitutional change who could go through without any basic voting basing on the
Did anyone else hear that bloke get his cock out mid-interview?
We're not royalists. Simple.
One incredible week of news. First up, you couldn't have missed this.
The Duke and Duchess of Cambridge show their love to each other and the world, married in Westminster Abbey with friends, family and dignitaries from across the globe.
It was a wonderful day. Two people in love, the sun was shining, we got a day off. As ever, the British public were very reserved.
Oh, look at William looking at her, look. I can't
believe it. It's magical! It is absolutely
love that. One minute she's speechless, next minute... They weren't the only ones. The crowd was full of brilliant nutters.
I made this costume all myself. With Yoo-hoo glue.
It wasn't just the public, even the police got into the party spirit. Mind you, it wasn't hard to get them going. The crowd cheered anything from the weather to a road sweeper.
There's a 10% chance of a shower during the service itself.
That's your mind.
It's like a car and a Hoover. For many people, view you.
It is actually very good.
For many people, the iconic image of the wedding was this.
Lots of shouts from the crowd here. And that's the reward.
Come on, the iconic wedding image was this little girl. Can't believe I put glue on my hands. Did you watch the service? When the priest asked if anyone objected to the wedding, did anyone else go, yeah? He's really punching above his weight. I love how many times they kept saying, Kate arrived a commoner and left a princess. Commoner? She's hardly Vicky Pollard.
Sorry, I'm Nick Wills. I was shoplifting down Primark.
The best bit was when William said, I take Kate to be my wife for richer and poorer. You could hear the entire nation going, poorer? Bollocks! Just before the ceremony, Harry took Wills off for a private word. I bet you money. He said, listen, Wills, I know it's your big day, but I'm definitely going to have a pop at Kate's sister. Who could blame him? She is extraordinary. You got to be all man, all man. Foxy Lee. I think I speak for the nation when I say she is a bmilf. A bridesmaid I'd love to Facebook. Talking on Facebook, within minutes of the service, this page was created. The Pippa Middleton Arse Appreciation Society. I wonder who set that up. The wedding, did anyone else notice the Queen didn't join in when they sang the national anthem? I reckon it's because she's so bored of it. She's probably there going, eh,
if I had a pound for every time they played that song. No, I do. Nice one.
I think she makes up lyrics in her head.
I'm missing bargain hunt. What shall I have for lunch? Maybe some chips. Do 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 do.
SpongeBob or Mr. T. I want a butler space monkey, 'cause I'm the
For a fact, the Queen's really into her music. Listen to what she was playing on the way to the service. I couldn't take my eyes off the Queen. Did you see what she wore? I was looking at her going, where have I seen that before? And then it hit me. The big fashion story, though, was definitely Kate's dress.
What will the bride be wearing and who has designed it?
All they really wanted to know, what dress will she wear?
It really will be one of the biggest fashion moments of all time.
My brother lost 50 quid at the bookies after he bet on Kate wearing this. The obvious fashion choice had to go to Tara Palmer Tompkins. Surely, if you've had to get a new nose because your old one was destroyed by drugs, don't wear a hat that points to it. It's like getting herpes and wearing this. Mind you, the hat was nothing compared to her sister. She has the poshest name ever.
That is her sister, Santa Seabag Montefiore. Santa Seabag Montefiore.
Santa Seabag Montefiore? That sounds like something this guy shouts when he comes. Everywhere you looked, people were wearing medals. David Beckham was there, looking great, wearing his OBE.
His medal there that he's got, but apparently we're being reliably informed that he is wearing it on the wrong side.
Imagine someone telling him, Dave, it's on the wrong side. All right.
Victoria, look, it's that bloke from the mask. It's the smoky.
Do you know the wedding was the biggest television event of all time? Did you see how many people watched it?
It's thought up to 2 billion people around the world watched them today exchange their vows.
Most of you probably watched it on the Beeb, which is a shame, because you missed out on the in-depth knowledge of Euro News. Listen to how they describe the flypast over Buckingham Palace.
All I can tell you is that that's a big plane, and it's got two little planes either side of it.
That is genius. It's great, isn't it? Mind you, that was nothing compared to the moment Chris Hollins was accidentally racist.
Have we had a super day today?
I've had a great day, thank you, great day!
Are you going home?
So, that's it for the royal wedding. Congratulations to Kate and Will. People were saying it's the best wedding ever. Ah, come on, it was good. It'll never beat this.
The rings, please.
So, the other major international news was this.
Fox News is just reporting that bin Laden, Osama bin Laden, is dead.
Did you see how the papers covered it? The Times went with, justice is done. The Express had, coward to the end. And what did the Sun go with? Bin bagged. The American reaction to bin Laden's death was fairly muted.
You kill innocent American people, you're gonna pay the price.
USA! USA! USA!
Osama bin Laden is dead. Happy days!
Did you see how they got rid of bin Laden's body?
We can now confirm that about an hour and a half ago, John, Osama bin Laden was buried at sea.
I love that description, bury. I think the verb they're searching for is flung. We found you, now you find Nemo. The bizarrest thing about this story, do you know the anagram you can make out of Osama bin Laden? Look at this, Osama bin Laden, lobbed a man in sea. Bin Laden's death sent the American networks into overload. Now, here's a tip. If you're reporting on one of the biggest stories of the year, make sure you know who killed who.
President Obama is, in fact, dead.
Well, he isn't, is he? The timing of this couldn't have been better for Obama. All week, he'd been dealing with this.
President Obama has released a full copy of his birth certificate to counter claims that he wasn't born in America.
Basically, right-wing extremists believe that Obama shouldn't be president because he wasn't born in America. I love the fact that a load of rednecks believe the Bible, but they don't believe Obama's American. I believe Jesus turned water into wine. I believe a virgin gave birth to God's child. But a black man born in America, that just don't make no sense. Wouldn't it be great if Obama went, my birth certificate, yeah, it's here, it's just in my trousers! It's pretty unfair. Nobody asked to see George Bush's birth certificate. In fairness, his mum was pretty busy. I'll call back later, Mrs. Bush, you look busy. I'll call back later. Now, Obama may have killed bin Laden and revealed his birth certificate, but for an old friend of the show, it still wasn't enough. Remember this guy?
Mr. Long, when they get Mac Daddy.
It's the preacher who hates Obama. He was back in the news. Have a listen to where he reckons the president got his birth certificate.
That fake birth certificate that Obama put, he bought it from down there in Mexico. Put on his website. He bought it from Mexico. Now all the Mexicans are saying, yay, amen, and whatever else it is they say in Mexico.
Part of the whole birth certificate business was the joke the president told at the White House correspondents' dinner. Check this out, it's brilliant.
Tonight, for the first time, I am releasing my official birth video.
That is a good gag. Hakuna Matata, a fucking tartar. I'm Barack Obama. So, what else has been happening? Well, have you seen the latest international crime fighter?
He's dressed head to toe in black. He's a self-styled ninja warrior, and he says he just wants to bring hope to ordinary citizens.
Pretty impressive. So, where does this all-powerful ninja operate? New York? Tokyo? A crime-fighting ninja has been patrolling the streets of Royal Tumbridge Wells. Tumbridge Wells? What crime does he deal with there? Somebody help! A lady's just served red wine with fish! It's so tragic, isn't it? I am the Tumbridge Wells ninja! Dad? Why are you wearing pajamas? Who is Dad? I am ninja! Dad, your cock's hanging out. So, what kind of ninja things has he been up to? Sword fighting? Throwing a Death Star?
He helped rescue his friend's cat from a tree.
He rescued a cat and now he's a ninja. Look what else he does.
Then he carried on doing other good deeds like helping old ladies cross the road.
What a ninja! Helping old ladies across the road. Only go when the light is green. Never fear, old lady, I am a ninja.
You look like a twat in pyjamas. And your cock's hanging out.
He's hardly helping. How scary would it be if you're an old lady and a bloke dressed in black goes, I'm taking you to the other side.
Oh, shit. Is it my time to die? I'll be honest, I never thought death would have his cock out.
I'm sure he's very good, but you hear Tumbridge Ninja, you don't picture this. You picture this. This next story is brilliant. Over in Australia, a member of the Navy has made the news after getting hammered whilst working in America.
This amateur video of a drunk Australian submariner being restrained by US guards is the latest in a string of embarrassing scandals for the Australian Defence Force.
He was absolutely wasted. They had to handcuff him to a stretcher. Now, the reason I love this story is because of the action the Australian Navy took.
The intoxicated sailor has since been promoted.
Just unbelievably brilliant. A farmer in Devon has come up with an unusual way to protect his flock.
How do you prevent your sheep from being stolen? Well, according to one farmer here on Dartmoor, you do this. You dye them orange.
Orange things don't get stolen. Well, this guy is safe from kidnap. So, wait, orange sheep would freak you out. Imagine cutting through that field on the way home from the pub.
Dave? The pumpkins are following me.
Dave? Is that a bloke in his pyjamas? Dave, I think his cock's hanging out. On the plus side, if all farmers start dyeing sheep orange, it'll really catch up perverts.
Hello, love. Good day tending the sheep.
It's all right. It's quite quiet, really.
What have you done?
What?
Unbelievably, that isn't the strangest animal story of the week. Nobody saw this affair coming.
They say love comes in all shapes and sizes. An 8-year-old swan named Swanee has developed a strange infatuation with a blue tractor.
Apparently a swan is in love with a tractor. I bet the other swans think he's a right pervert. They're in the lake kissing, he's in his bedroom with a load of tissues watching Top Gear.
Pop her bonnet.
Probably the worst impression of a swan you'll ever see. Let's be honest, the love between a swan and a tractor can only end one way. This is the part of the show I genuinely don't know anything about. There's going to be a mystery guest who's been in the news, and I have to figure out who that person is. So, please welcome my mystery guest!
Hello.
Hello, nice to meet you. Hello. Hey, Joe, nice to meet you. There you go, look at that. Pretty cool. Is that the first time you've been on telly?
No.
Oh, OK, I was going to say, because within seconds you got a wolf whistle. It's pretty cool. Can I look underneath your curtains?
No.
OK. Well, the first lady's refused that. OK, I'm guessing it has something to do with bric-a-brac, collecting things. Do you collect things?
No.
You don't collect things. Do you work with children? There's Germany's different
I
flag.
Do.
You work with children?
I work with children.
And what's...
OK, so the medals are something to do with it.
Right, it's got something to do with medals. Mm-hmm. Have you competed?
Yes.
Against children? That's why you won the medal? I can win medals against
kids. My day job is working with children.
Your day job is working with kids, but by night you win...
Something different.
Something different, OK. Are you an athlete?
Yes.
You're an athlete, excellent. Yes. What do you do, am I allowed to ask?
I'm 15 times British champion.
Yep.
In...
Yep.
Have you guessed yet?
Oh, arm wrestling.
Yeah.
Right, so...
Have you ever arm wrestled before?
No, I'm going to get beaten up yet again. Oh, the imagination of my production team.
How about I'll show you a few techniques.
Just getting beat up again. Go on.
I'll show you a few techniques,
just punch me in
yeah?
the face. Just get out of the way. It's all people want to see. Just tech me. Hang on.
I'll show you a few techniques, right?
Yep.
Okay, so we stand up. You hold your peg. There we go. Okay, the first technique.
You smell lovely.
Thank you. Ah,
yeah!
Okay, a top roll.
Top roll.
Right, it's a little technique for you.
Yeah.
With this part of your hand.
Yeah.
You need to open my fingers so I'm like this.
Okay.
And then you drag me down to the back. Okay. Nice and easy for you, I'll show you.
So you go like that.
So like this.
Sure, okay.
Do you want to practice? Right, use your body weight a bit more. So drag your body. Yeah. And then... Okay. Yeah, that's fair. All right, next one. It's called a hook. So the strongest person normally wins this when this technique's been used.
It's gonna be you.
So you hook both wrists in.
Yep.
And drag back.
Aye, yes.
Keep
going. Really try. Ready?
Yeah.
Yeah. Can you improvise?
All right, so I'll show you a few things now. So
now,
shall we see how
commence
you can
with
use
the beating. Yep, yeah. Okay.
So choose one in your head that you're gonna choose. Ready?
Yeah.
Three, two,
go.
One.
No, you didn't let me win. Don't let me win.
You win.
I feel like a child. You can eat from the adult menu. Let me eat my own food.
All right.
Oh, come on, then.
For the last one,
yep.
I'll show you how we do it in a professional competition.
Okay. Wow, I can already feel it. Damn.
You give me a go.
I'll give you a go. Let's have a chat. It's easier. Have you got a boyfriend?
Yes.
Now, I don't want to get base. But there are certain things that a man and lady can do.
That women
he
can do
be
better.
He must be terrified when you do it. I'm talking, of course, about pancake flipping.
Of course.
Which is a different thing to call it. So, you're very, very strong. How did you start this? Can you beat your dad?
My dad was the British heavyweight champion.
Right.
He built me a little table when I was little.
Yeah.
And when I was seven, I entered a sub-junior competition for fun and beat about six boys.
Did you? Wow. And then, cool. How old were they? Were they your age or were
they was between six and nine.
Excellent.
So, yeah. And then when I was 11, I entered the British Championships and won it, and from then on, won it.
Fantastic. Well, it's lovely to meet you. Thank you. I've really enjoyed
that. Nice to meet you.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, please give up for our mystery guest. Have you seen the latest way some teenagers are tackling exams? It's a new pill called a smart drug. Apparently, it makes you more intelligent.
Some swear they're the secret to maximising memory power, to aid exams, to boost concentration, and to help stay alert for hours at a time. These are smart drugs, and a recent survey said 1 in 10 students were taking them.
Kids are taking smart drugs? Who's their dealer? This guy? Do you know what I'd do if I was still at school? Just before an exam, I'd offer my mate some smart pills, and instead, I'd give them Viagra. Wouldn't that be fantastic? They're trying to do algebra with a massive rod on. Teachers walking around. My God, these kids really love maths. I'm not going to use these smart pills. Why? Because I know I'd leave them lying around and my dog would eat them and that would freak me out.
Greetings, Russell. You're Archie's. I'm fine, thank you. Did you know all polar bears are left-handed and there are no cats in the Bible? In other news, I've done a shit in his shoes.
As ever with a story like this, the papers are shrieking, this is terrible, all children are taking them. Calm down. Not all teenagers are taking smart pills, as these exam answers prove. Briefly explain what hard water is. Ice. Explain the shape of the graph. It's curvy. And my personal favourite. Can a man still reproduce with only one testicle? No. Girls don't find that shit attractive. Time for my final story. This is beautiful, right? It's an inspirational story about a father and his son who compete in marathons and triathlons across America.
This is where they go to prove their mettle. Endurance racers from around New England, ready to take on an Olympic distance triathlon. Those who finish will swim a mile, bike 24, and run six more.
All right, welcome everyone.
But one man's got a tougher challenge than the rest. And it's not because he's one of the oldest guys here. It's because Dick Hoyt will pull, pedal, and push his son Rick, who was born without the ability to move or speak. Dick and Rick Hoyt have completed over 240 triathlons, and on their lazier Sunday afternoons, over 68 marathons, the fastest in a time just half an hour off the world record.
I just don't have the desire to be out there running by myself. I think it's just something that comes from his body to my body, and it makes us go faster.
Are you trying to say that you run faster pushing Rick than if you didn't run with him?
Oh, yeah. He inspires me and he motivates me. And he's actually the athlete, and he's very competitive. He wants to win.
I have shown to disabled people that they don't have to sit back and watch the world go by.
There you go. Saturday night, which means it's time for my stand-up guest. This guy's wonderful. I've gigged with him many times. He's also a co-host on Frank Skinner's Absolute Radio show. So, genuine pleasure to have him. Ladies and gentlemen, please go wild and crazy for Gareth Richards!
Hello.
Hi.
Hello. How are you doing? Are you having a nice evening? Excellent. My name is Gareth. Say hello, Gareth. Hello, everybody. I've been doing some research recently, and Gareth is an ancient Welsh name that means man with shit name. Thank you for coming. I'm going to put that over there. Brilliant. So I've come from Bournemouth to be here today. Is there anyone in from Bournemouth? I live in Bournemouth with my wife. I'm married. Give me a cheer if you're married. Give me a cheer if you're single. Much happier. Much happier. I've been married 8 years, so I married quite young. People say to me, "Her married young, did you? Her, was she pregnant? Was she pregnant?" And I'm like, "No." As it turned out. Nasty shock and lovely surprise, that was all at the same time. So I got the train here. Anyone been on the train recently? Oh, it's good on the train now. They've got plug sockets on the train now. Have you seen this? Plug sockets on the train. It's like living in the future. How do they get electricity on a train? Is there a man in the back with an extension lead going? And by the plug socket, there's a sticker to give us some instructions. Because they know if they don't give us some instructions, we'll just freak out. And it says, laptops and mobile phones only. And I'm always like, oh, and I've brought my ironing. When was I supposed to get this done? Right, you watch out for the man for me, and I'm just going to get as much of this done as I can before he gets... Wait, sorry, this is still a bit damp. Sorry, do you mind if I plug my tumble dryer in there? Is that... I went to Wimbledon last year. I went to Wimbledon and this young guy came up to me and he said, I'm a ball boy. I said, oh, I'm more of a breast man myself. Wooden spoons are handy because you can use wooden spoons to prepare food. Or if you haven't got time for that, just write a number on one, go into a pub and say, where's my dinner? I ordered hours ago. So we're political people here on Russell Howard's Good News. How do we feel about the coalition? That's the exact sound everyone makes all over the country. That's the sound of our political opinions. People thought the Conservatives were going to win really easily in the last election, and I think they should have rebranded themselves more and they would have done better because they've had to do this sharing thing. And, you know, because they should have rebranded more, because some people call them the Conservatives, some people call them the Tories. I think they should call themselves the Conservatories. Making the Houses of Parliament more transparent. One of the first things they said they were going to do was cut down on speed cameras. How do we feel about that, cut down on speed cameras? Good news for motorists, not so good for school children. Then we do want to save money on education, so... I live near my parents in Bournemouth, and mums are lovely, but they are a bit embarrassing, aren't they? I think there's something about happens to a woman when they have another human being burst out of them one day. Just makes them lose all sense of what's normal and appropriate in everyday life for the rest of their life. The other day, my mum wanted to mime to me, Gareth, would you like a glass of wine? This is the mime she did. She says, Gareth, would you like a... I'm like, Mum, that is not the mime for would you like a drink? Not much of a drink, anyway. But there's reasons why people do comedy. Something's had to have gone wrong somewhere in your life you to need this sort of attention. And one of these moments for me is I was 10 years old and it was bath time and my mum and my auntie were there. And I start to get... This isn't as bad as it sounds like it's going to be. There's social workers in the front row who are worried. Now I start to get changed. And I throw them a look as if to say, yeah, you can go now. And my mum says, oh, come on, we should go now. He doesn't like me to see him get changed anymore. Now he's growing up a little bit. He's shy of himself. Now he's getting a little bit older. We should give him his privacy. We should go. And this next bit of the conversation, they were still in the room when they had this conversation. This is in my mind for me to deal with for the rest of my life. My mum says, we should go. And my auntie says, oh, why? Has it grown? And my mum said, no. Part of me died right there and then. But you know, your parents worry about you, and that's a lovely thing, but every now and then they say something that betrays how much they worry about you, the terrible things that go through their minds. Every time my mum used to take a picture of me, she used to say, smile, Gareth, because if you go missing tomorrow, this will have to be on the news. Nobody's going to look for a miserable child. Jeez! I hated school all the way through. I hated it. We have communal showers at our school. Do you have communal showers at your school? No, they stopped doing it because it's very cruel. When you're right on the brink of puberty, the most self-conscious you'll ever be about your body, and they make you shower in front of your whole class. I'd like to shower with 30 12-year-olds now and see who the weirdo is. My English teacher hated me when I was at school. He's always like, Gareth, you'll never amount to anything. You'll never do anything with your life. And I said to him, mark my words, that's your job. I'm moody, I'm a bit melancholic. Sometimes I feel alone in the universe, like a tiny speck of nothing in an ocean of emptiness. And then I'll have a cup of... Thank you. And then I'll have a cup of tea and a Kit Kat and just feel much better. Just low blood sugar. That's all it was. I thought I was deep, I was just peckish. And I was a morbid kid. I remember I got into trouble once at school for saying to my RE teacher, I said, all right then, if heaven's so brilliant, why don't we all just kill ourselves and go there? Right, now, if a 10-year-old boy said that to you, would that encourage you to take your own life? No, she must have been on the brink anyway. So I suppose the big news in my life is 2 years ago, my wife and I had a little boy. Aww. Thank you. He's a good one. Yeah, no, we're pleased with him, definitely. You know when you get something new, you compare it to the ones other people have got. Well, there's some freaky-looking babies out there. But he's a good one. We're going to keep him, definitely. He's by far the best thing that's ever happened as a result of one of my bodily functions. His name's Ethan. Ethan Richards, not a bad name. If we had a girl, I wanted to call her Adele, you know, after my laptop. I realised I'd had a negative attitude about babies, about children, you know. I've been prejudiced against children, is the truth of it. People worry about all sorts of things nowadays. People worry about asylum seekers and immigrants, things like that. I don't worry about that. I think that's a load of racist nonsense. I think, what about babies? You know, they come here, they don't speak the language. Start claiming benefits as soon as they get here. They won't wear the same clothes or eat the same food as us, so they have to have their own special shops. Also, we let as many of them in here as they want. As soon as we try and get where they came from, very strict border controls in that direction. So I thought I'd end with a song. How do we feel about that? They put a special bit of tape for me to know exactly how low to put the mic stand. So if anyone's worried about, is that mic stand high enough? It is. So, ladies and gentlemen, this is the Omnicord. Yeah. Omni means really, chord means brilliant. I'm going to show you what this baby can do. The Omnicord is a three-pronged attack on music. The first thing it does is the beat. The second thing it does is the chord sound. Hey? Now, there's one more thing this baby does. Are you ready for this? This metallic strip here makes a harp sound. Oh, yeah. My friend Dave is a little bit square, just like a fridge. My friend Dave hasn't got any hair, just like a fridge. Doesn't listen to what you say. He likes to pretend that everything's okay. And Dave keeps things the same way every day. Just like a fridge. Just like a fridge. My friend Dave is white. Just like a fridge. Dave doesn't wash, so he gently hums just like a fridge. His light comes on when you open the door. You can only use Dave for what Dave is for. And Dave at a party is a bit of a bore. just like a fridge. Just like a fridge. My friend Dave is cold inside, just like a fridge. But he's warm if you touch him on the back, just like a fridge. Dave's dad is called Eric and his mum is Joanne. Whilst travelling in East Asia, their romance began. And that's how come Dave was made in Japan. Just like a fridge. Just like a fridge. We thought that Dave would always be alone, just like a fridge. Cause Dave is not very good at talking to girls, just like a fridge. He found someone to call his own. We finally met her when he brought her home, but she couldn't quite fit into the living room. She was massive, just like a fridge. Just like a fridge. Just like a fridge. Thank you very much. You've been lovely. I'll be back with you. See you later. Goodbye.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Gareth Richards. There you go. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for watching Good News. Have a fantastic Saturday night.
Farewell.